So, good afternoon, everyone. Yeah, I'm Sunny, SUSE employee and openSUSE member. Actually, I'm one of the founders of openSUSE Asia Summit. So, firstly, welcome to this topic. 5 years ago is my first time to visit Indonesia. So today I'm very happy to come back to this beautiful country again, and especially for this open source event. Today I will share my story of open source and also tell the story of other women about open source, and then we analyze what blocks women embracing open source and how we attract more women in the open source community. Before I joined SUSE, I worked on two projects in previous company. One of them was a monitor system which runs on both Linux and Windows. And the other one was a navigation system, which code comes from an open source project. I would say at that time, I didn't have much idea about open source. I just simply used the Linux command and operations. So I really kick off my open source journey from SUSE. During my journey of open source, there are three events impressed me very much. The first one is SUSE Lab Conference 2010. And I attended this conference as exchange program. In SUSE R&D, each quarter from each location, there is an engineer as exchange program candidate travel to the other sites with SUSE office and talk to the engineer there. Exchange tech knowledge and the cultures with the engineer. So it was the first time for me to talk with our colleagues in different countries face to face. So that impressed me very much. The second one is openSUSE Conference 2011. Compared with SUSE Lab Conference, actually the SUSE Lab Conference was an internal conference hosted by SUSE. But openSUSE conference is quite different. That's real community conference. So in this conference, I talk with the community contributor from all over the world. I was proud of being a member of them and co-work with them to contribute to openSUSE. Two colleagues and I were sponsored by GNOME and SUSE to attend Guardec 2012. There was a video which reviewed the whole conference, was appeared at the closing session of that conference. And my personally appeared in that video, very big photo. So at that time, I was wondering why my photo was there, because I don't believe I'm the prettiest girl in that conference, but my photo was there. So I concluded there are because only a few Asian people attend the conference, and I'm the only Asian female. So as we know, Guardec stands for GNOME Users and Developers European Country. The European number is definitely majority, but I thought Asian people should more active. So at that time, I made up my mind to promote open source upon my return. That's also one of the reasons why I co-work with my colleagues and also the openSUSE members to start with the openSUSE Asia Summit. When I prepared this topic, I thought different women might have different story with open source. So I interviewed women around me and get to know how they be involved in the open source and how they get to know the open source. Mostly I got these answers. Some women told me they really enjoyed the working experience with their juniors from all over the world, because they can co-work with them and communicate with them. And also some women get to know open source from their husband and friends. Some young women learn Linux at school, so they get to know open source from school. And also there are some women which are look for the freedom and get involved in the open source community. I asked one question during my interview is, why do you fall in love with open source? And what attracted you in the open source community? I got these answers. Some people think they love to work with the juniors from all over the world. And also, some women told me, if you imagine work on a non-open source project in a company, if you left a company, you cannot touch this project anymore. However, if you work on an open source project, you can always be with this good project wherever you are. Because the open source community involves people from all over the world. They are from different countries, different cultures. So you can see there are many awesome ideas and a lot of brainstorm in the open source project. Some women also told me they like the recognition by the community and their contribution can be recorded forever. I took a video for some of them and I would see the video with you together. But firstly, I'm sorry because the video sometimes a bit louder and sometimes not. So if it's really louder and scare you, I'm so sorry first.
My dear fellow organizers and attendees of openSUSE Asia Summit, I'm Gu Shi, co-founder of the Women Tech Community TechiCat.
Hi everyone, my name is Yun Qigou. You can call me Iris. I come from Beijing, China, and I am a graduate student of George Washington University now. My major is computer science. I wrote code, committed pull requests, did some researches on the situation of Chinese open source communities and did some paperwork before. And I believe I will keep going.
I'm working for Microsoft now. I see a big changes in the past few years. A lot of great open source efforts has come across the company. The CEO of Microsoft is Microsoft.Linux. This is really change the world. And I'm very proud to be part of it. And besides my work in Microsoft, in my spare time, I was a co-member of the Kaiyuan Show. Now I'm a board member of the Kaiyuan Show. Kaiyuan Show is an open source alliance, and we are going to make it a bridge between the international open source community and the China open source community. I'll continue working on it.
From customers or community and fixed bus to LVM. And besides my daily work, I also send patches to many open source communities like resource agents, like DRPD and batch compilations, etc. Whenever I see a bug of the open source software, I will get the source code and send a patch to the community.
Currently, I'm working at SUSE at QA, and also I am active in some local Linux user groups and VM user groups, and offering some help for others.
They are, but I guess I can count them with my fingers, which I feel very sad about. And I do hope there are more women that get to know about open source and to join us and also be part of our community.
The women participate, the number in the open source community is not very high, about 5%, so the total participation is very low. But however, if you know a woman in open source community, she is going to be a very influential leader. For example, like a feature maker in the Mozilla, like a Karen Sander from a Free Software Conservancy, and also Sally Sun from the Open Source community. So those are very influenced people.
There are many, but our female community is definitely growing, so it's great. And I would encourage all of you, either both female and male, to get involved.
There are only a few female in working on open source community, I think.
I have to admit that there are some women in open source community, but not many. We still have to do something to attract them.
I firstly know Creative Commons, which is an NGO helping people locally share knowledge and creativity. Then I was invited to be one of the speakers at open source conference by Kaiyuan Shen last year. I guess that's how I get started to be one of the members of open source community.
When I was a junior student at Beijing University of Posts and Telecommunications, I took a course called Linux. I found myself so interested in it, and I began to take part in the local open source communities such as Beijing User Group and Beijing User Group. And I'm also the volunteer of Broad Asia 2040 and openSUSE Asia 2040. Both of them were held in China.
I joined the Sun Microsystem 10 years ago. At that time, some open source domain projects like Noon. I participated in the GNU project since then, and in 2008 I started and founded the GNU Asian Summit to bring the GNU community to Asia. And also in 2010, I was selected as the board of directors of GNU Foundation. So from then, I was heavily involved in the open source community. My open source journey started from then.
Kind. So I first started as a translator for several projects, including Ubuntu. Then I graduated from college and was working for both Oracle and SUSE as software quality assurance engineer. So that's
I got to know open source community when I was a graduate student at school. At that time in my lab, all the students used the Linux for their operating system. Because students have no money, so Linux is our first choice. And I still remember I set up my first high availability cluster based on Linux 2.4. I also did some development and research work on many open source projects like LVS and Squid and Jabber, etc. And we learned a lot from open source projects.
After take a several course about Linux and some basic operations, I got to know the Linux and some open source projects and GNOME projects. And I joined some local Linux user groups and other communities. And I got to know many friends, and I even met my boyfriend in a VIM user group 6 years ago.
Open source community is a cosmopolitan and friendly platform sharing spirit of freedom and dedication. As a women tech community, we have always been advocating the value of sharing of open source, and we definitely encourage our women to know and to be contributors of open source. And we also look forward to cooperating with different tech communities around the world. Thank you. Hope you enjoy the assignment.
Open source is full of joy for me, and I really feel I'm making contributions and let more people get involved. Sharing spirits and freedom are just my opinion. Everyone can find his place and make contributions. Meanwhile, they are many friendly people who can help you in the open source community. So don't worry if you are not
the open source community is an open place. Everyone can come, can join, can contribute. And people here are inspired by the spirit, by the reputation. It is a place that you have your own voice. So it is a place that you, once you come, it is hard to leave.
Another important thing is it gives me a sense of accomplishment, which is truly, truly important for me.
I suppose most people are attracted by open source values and principles that is open and free, which means the software, the source code are free of charge. You have freedom to share and distribute it. But what attracts me most is the way open source works. That all the people share and collaborate together and to work in a way that is transparent. We can when we discuss a feature or problem in the mailing list or GitHub, everybody can watch it and join it. The way open source, the way open source work, make the software can quickly improve, and you can also work with people from all over the world, and that's the great enjoyment I work on the open source world.
I'm not a user anymore. I continue to try to be a developer and Once I find project needs improvement, I can contribute to that quickly and easily.
Okay, so after we see this video, you might curious about one question. So John, open source community is really a good experience, but why we only have a few female in this community compared with the overwhelming number of men? So what block women from embarrassing open source? I think if you randomly talk with women about open source in the street, the first reaction you probably got is they will answer you, I have no idea about what is open source, or I don't know what contribution I can do for the open source community if I because I'm not majoring in science and technology. So I think we need to find a suitable way to promote open source to women. My personal opinion is open source community have the similarity with IT company. So let's see which department have more women in IT company compared with the other department. So generally, women's personality is take care of people's feeling, good at communication and process orientation. So we can see, you know, IT company, this department have more women. For example, documentation, administration, marketing, finance, and QA. Mapping to open source community, these works might attract women. For example, marketing, documentation, translation, QA, design, finance. If the women around you is really good at writing, you can introduce documentation to them. If they are good at English, you might talk with them about translation. So here, it doesn't mean the women are not fit for R&D, but I think this task can easily attract the women to contribute to open source at the very beginning, especially when they are not majoring in science and technology. In the meanwhile, we need to promote open source frequently and widely. So please talk to the women around you about open source and help them get to know what is open source. Today, we choose this university as the venue of openSUSE Asia Summit, which is a smart decision. Because the young people are eager to learn the new knowledge and they have passion and time to contribute on what they loved. So please talk to the student and especially the school girl about open source. Okay, here I would back to the original question is, do we have to have women in the open source community? So in China, we believe Taiji. I'm not sure if everybody here know what is Taiji. But Taiji indicates the maintaining of balance between yin and yang is very important because it follows up the natural law. If we look at the specific case, for example, in QA team, if we have more women, our project quality could be better. So I do believe it does make sense to include and have more women in this open source community. So far, it seems we have covered all the things we want to talk today. However, if I have an enchanted lamp, I would make three wishes here. Firstly, please be friendly and be patient to the new female comer. Welcome them and help them. Secondly, please take your wife or your girlfriends to the open source event and party, because during the interview you can see there are some women really get to know the open source from their husband and friends. I have a kid who is 9 years old. So mostly I spend my private time with my son and with my family. So I'm really looking forward to having more good open source project which fits for both adults and kids, so that I can contribute to open source with my son together. And today my son is one of the auditors. And I hope someday he stand on this stage and tell his romance with open source. Because I do believe open source not only belong to us, but also belong to the young kids. And in the future, they will become the mainstay of the open source community. Open source is in our DNA. Is it in yours? Please join us at SUSE or openSUSE. I copied this slide with the papers. I will put this paper in the reception desk. If you want to see the open positions in SUSE, just take the paper and visit the link in this paper, and also or talk with me face to face. It's an easy way. So that's all for today. Thank you and terima kasih. I think we beat over time, but I do really encourage you, the female, ask me question or share their experience. And I prepare three small gifts for the women who ask me the question.
Okay, she has three. Price for women.
Three. Yeah.
Hanya female, women. Siapa tunjuk jari?
You can either ask me question or talk something about your.
Itu paling belakang selfie apa tunjuk tangan itu yang paling belakang. Selfie apa tunjuk tangan tadi? Monggo, putri yang putri, mbak. Mbaknya mau nanya ya. Calon bilang calon itu enggak.
Ah, we got question there.
Oke. Okay. Satu. Masih kurang dua. Ada tiga price. Dua kurang satu.
Sekalian maju, Mbak. Maju sekalian. Ya. Maju. Sekalian maju.
Oh, I have my mic here. Okay, thank you very much for the material that you have given to us. This is awesome, and the video is so inspiring for me. I want to ask you how to, for the beginners, including in Indonesia, how we can develop our women community in open source, just like that. Because I am too confused how to start it, how to make it become a big development, big community that you have.
Yeah, thank you for your question. I think some people might think language is a problem, maybe for non-English native speaker, but that's not true. I do encourage women at the beginning just go through the either open SUSE website to see what team they have, or you find what are you good at, and then get involved in. We have some IRC channel, you can either talk with the guy there, or just get some documentation materials from the website directly. So more frequently you talk to the people, more idea you will get.
Maybe you can share a little bit. Actually, we are so rarely to find out if women interesting in open source. Sometimes we have community, we can hang out together and talk about technology, but sometimes it's rarely to find if there's women that interesting in open source.
Yeah, so do you mind I show you the link after the conference? Because I rarely have time.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you. Later.
Okay, I want to ask you about what makes you interested in open source, especially openSUSE.
That's a good question. Actually, I would say I don't know what's the real time I really fall in love with open source. But as I said, after I joined SUSE, I really kick off my open source journey because the people around you talk with you about open source project and we are also contribute to the open source community. For example, today there are some volunteers. I see this is also kinds of contribution to the open source community. Thank you.
Thank you.
The last question from Mimi.
Kurang satu. Oh ya, akhirnya.
I want to share. I want to share my experience in here in Indonesia. Yeah. Okay, Indonesia aja ya.
Yes, please.
Sorry. Saya ingin share, jadi ini adalah pengalaman pertama saya untuk berani bicara di depan orang-orang banyak seperti ini, di depan kalian. Saya berani mensubmit paper saya mengenai open source, padahal saya bukan orang yang sudah bertahun-tahun menggunakan open source, bukan. Dengan bergabung dengan Gelit, bukan maksud untuk promosi, tapi benar, dengan bergabung dengan mereka, saya punya keberanian yang cukup untuk memacu saya untuk berani. Ayo, wanita itu nggak cuma ngikut-ngikut aja gitu, kita juga harus berani untuk melakukan sesuatu yang baru gitu. Terima kasih.
Aku kasih sharing his experience about. This is the first time she's speaking in international conference.
Okay.
Because she's joined with the FOSS community in our city. So she shared about how FOSS community make she's brave to speaking in front of people. So she's love FOSS because of it, like this.
Yeah, that's a good start. Thank you. So give me 10 seconds. I would ask one question to all the men in this room.
One man.
All the men answer me the question.
All men.
Men. Okay. So
maybe you can choose the text.
Okay. My question is: after you listen to my presentation, in the future, will you take your girlfriends or your wife to the open source community? If yes, raise up your hand. Okay. I see some people didn't raise up their hands. Can I assume they don't have girlfriends?